Thanks for staying with us. All right, we're going to talk about a topic that's sometimes difficult to discuss, as those who deal with domestic violence victims will tell you, not talking about it can have devastating and even deadly consequences. So today we're welcoming Scooter Stein. He's the Director of Public Affairs for the Fayette County Sheriff's Office, and Anita Franklin. She's a community outreach coordinator, to talk about an event that is going to help raise awareness of domestic violence. Thank you both so much for being here.
Thank you for having us on.
Well, first of all, can we just start out by talking about domestic violence and maybe the perimeters of what all that includes?
Yes, so domestic violence, a lot of people think is physical abuse, physical contact, and it's important to note that those aren't the only indicators. It could be verbal, controlling behaviors, not allowing someone to spend their own money, always asking and checking in, following them on their phone. It's the whole range of factors that allow for one person to exert too much of an influence on the life of someone else.
Sure, and I'm so glad that you said that, because often when we think about victims of domestic violence, we expect to see bruises or cuts or injuries, and it's not always that way.
It's not.
Certainly.
Is there a stigma involved with coming out and talking about being a victim of these behaviors?
It is. A lot of people remain silent because they're embarrassed, and they don't want that label placed on them, that I'm a victim, that I'm weak. And so that's absolutely not what domestic violence is about. It's about being strong and speaking out about that.
And that's why you're holding this vigil this Thursday.
Correct.
Now tell us about what's going on.
So on Thursday night, we are going to have the third annual Domestic Violence Candlelight Vigil. This is the third year. We started in 2017, and this is a very important event, not only for our office, for Sheriff Witt as well. We do have a domestic violence unit that's 24 hours and works around the clock on domestic violence. And a few years back, there were a couple of domestic violence murders in October in Domestic Violence Awareness Month, which floored us and really brought us down, because we thought, what can we do as a community to get our message out, to say that this is not okay, that all of us are involved in this?
Right.
And so with that, we decided to have this wonderful vigil, and we had a great community response. And so it has become an annual event for us.
You know, and so often it's easy to tell just how much of an impact you're having with the community by how many people come out and actually take part in it. And the fact that so many people are so supportive of this vigil, that shows just how needed an event like this is here in Lexington.
We're thankful with all of the community partners. We've received food donations, balloon donations. We have groups that are coming to paint rocks all over the place. This will be a family-friendly event, but this is an event that we couldn't put on without our community partners. We'll have a resource fair where individuals can come and they can show how they're helping in the campaign that we have together as a community to end domestic violence.
And one thing, we are also honoring the memory of victims of domestic violence, and then we open our arms and support survivors. And we are going to have an open mic where survivor victims can get up and tell their story. And telling your story equals freedom.
Sure, it's a healing.
It does.
And you also help other people know they're not alone.
Absolutely.
So what are the details of this? We know that it's serious, but it's also family friendly. Like you said, there's going to be food, all kinds of fun stuff as well. Mm-hmm. How do we get involved?
So we will begin at 5:30 in front of the Courthouse Plaza. It'll be right in front of the District Court on North Limestone. And at the beginning, you'll see resource tables. You'll see a whole bunch of community organizations that do work with us and that work to help individuals. There will be food, there will be games for kids. We're gonna have motivational speakers. Anita's been working really hard on that, so I'll let her speak. We're gonna have lovely, wonderful music, and this is an event where we are going to come together as a community, and by the end, when the sun is down, we will light our candles together.
It's sure to be a very, very impactful night. Is there somewhere online we can go to get more information?
Yes, so we have a Facebook event. It's called In the Silence, the third annual Domestic Violence Candlelight Vigil, off of our Facebook page. So we are the Fayette County Sheriff's Office, KY. We've blasted it around. It's circulating. We hope you'll look on Facebook. It is a public event. Tell us your thoughts, what you'd like to see. Discuss what We are here to make this a great community event, and it is for the community.
Absolutely. We appreciate you both so much for being here and for what you're doing. Definitely go to that Facebook page, check it out, and head out to the courthouse downtown Thursday night. Thanks again. We'll be right back.